Here's Martin Denny with a, oh my goodness, a lot of things. We'll be here till 9 o'clock tonight.
Thank you. fond of music. And here's one that seems would apply to all of us as young people. Stoma. It was called Klein Village. And this is when I was appearing at the Shell Barn, the Hawaiian Village, and which it comes as Hawaiian Village. I don't know, do you folks remember me having performed there? That goes back to 1956. That's 43 years ago, right? Yeah. We're all a lot younger. But anyway, the story behind us, how did I ever get to, people say, how did I get to put all these bird sounds and the animal sounds? And there's a little story behind that. It's like, when I was appearing with the group there, the Shell Bar was open, and right next door, right next to the bandstand, there was a pond, and there were some bullfrogs in there. And I noticed when we were playing the song that they were croaking, you know. And when they stopped playing, they stopped croaking, you know. And I thought, well, that was quite a coincidence. So a little while later, I thought, well, I'll try it again, just to see if they start croaking again. Sure enough, they started croaking. And so suddenly, the boys in the band started to improvise, started doing bird calls with us. And everybody sort of cracked up, I mean, you see. So the following day, a gentleman walked up to me and he said, "Mr. Denny, would you do that arrangement with the birds and the frogs?" And I said, "Well, you've got to be kidding, you know." But then it dawned on me, well, you know, it makes kind of sense. So I had a rehearsal and I said, "Arthur, you do a call," and four measures later, Ogie comes Kalakaua, you do a call, and then with John Kramer, you do a call. And I got a little scratcher thing that sounded like a frog when you scratched it next to the microphone. Ribbit. And that was the birth of Quiet Village. And you people would come in, that's all they wanted to hear all night long. It was 15, 20 requests a night that I was playing. So remarkably enough, it is, you know, it hit the charts eventually, and I got the gold record on it, and it was a million seller. And to this day, it is still being played nationally as well as in Europe, in Japan. So anyway, minus the band and the bird calls. If you want to join in the bird calls, be my guest. Section and all the instruments that go with this. Augie Colonna did a lot of those bird calls, lives in Molokai. And he has a son, right now he's going to San Diego College, who has been clocked at pitching the ball at 90 miles an hour. He's only 19 years old, and he's being scouted by major leagues at this point. Isn't that something? I keep in touch with some of the boys. The original group consisted of myself, Arthur Lyman on vibes, and John Kramer. Now, as you know, Arthur played vibes, and later, after he left my group, he formed his own group, and he received national prominence. And in fact, he told me he performed here this couple weeks ago, didn't he?
Arthur?
Yeah, he played vibes. And then Arthur, and then let me say, John Kramer is now a vice president with Prudential Securities. He's making more money than a musician, I assure you. And then later on, of course, I ended up in Cologne, who's extraordinary in talent. And through the years, sadly enough, I mean, he was, Martin was replaced by Julius Wechter, one of the greatest talents I ever had. He passed away less than a month ago. And really, one of the great talents I've ever had. He contributed a great deal towards my recordings and the success that I enjoyed. And I did a eulogy for him recently on the local 47, and I printed a picture of the original group with him in it. I'm going to do some original effects of mine. This was a great favorite in Japan. It's called Firecrackers. Japan called the Hello Magic Orchestra, and it was, they used synthesizers, and the arrangement on it was just extraordinary. It's very modern, I guess. And believe it or not, it has been recorded, that is, the rhythm section has been recorded by a rap group who set lyrics to it. So can you imagine some of my pieces are being played by a rap orchestra? Well, you know, come think about it, John, he does a rap number, don't you?
No, I used to.
Well, you still do. He does a rap on nursery rhymes, you know. But you know who did that long before they heard the rap? Was George Burns. George Burns used to do that, you know? Mm-hmm. You remember him? And look at him, quite a hundred, yeah. Let me see what we do. I'll play something that... probably romantic things that go back to our period. Oh, yes.
Could you play something that was really
they liked
in British Columbia?
Something in British Columbia?
Yeah.
Like what?
Well, I don't know anything that...
I don't know British Columbia. Is there any, you mean a Canadian
yeah.
songs?
Yeah.
I already said it.
When you came up there.
On Vancouver?
Yeah.
Yeah, I performed up there a number of times. Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, let me see, there was something called that I can't see.
Thank you.
Well, I guess in all the years that I've been playing, I started playing when I was piano. I started studying when I was 10 years old. And of course, next week and week or so, I'm going to be 88. So that covers a lot of territory. So, but my background primarily was classical. I used to play classical. And of course, I got involved in modern music over the years and traveled a lot. I spent 4.5 years in South America, which contributed a lot to the sounds of the later years. It has a Latin influence. I spent 3.5 years in Buenos Aires. So we have some guests here that are from Colombia. Some very dear friends. Let's see. So that's hello. So, and by the time I ever get to talk Spanish, that's an around. But apart from my classical and everything, I did play jazz, you know. You may not be as happy. So I'll play something, a little jazz waltz for you. Thank you. one of my favorite composers, and I think had an impact on my playing a lot, was George Gershwin, who to me was one of the great American composers. And, you know, the story, I never got to meet him personally. I wish I had, because but he died, I think, at the age of 34 years old. What a talent, you know. And so many wonderful things he had. Of course, he wrote a folk opera. It's called Porgy and Bess. And I'll play some of the things that you'd recognize.
Thank you.
hops, skips, and jumps. That's right. I used to be able to play a piece of terribly. You know. You want to interrupt me?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, we have several functions here besides just listening to the beautiful music that's being played by Arthur here today. We're celebrating. What did I say? We have birthdays to celebrate. His 88th and Arthur's 89th. We have a cake over here, which we invite you to take a piece of it with you and before dinner, and then you won't eat so much. We also would like Martin to just play a few notes on this piano. Now, this is an electronic piano, digital piano. It will be in a multipurpose room, and there are many groups that we'd like to have asked in here to play in there on Fridays and other times. But because we didn't have a piano in there, Alice donated her piano, Alice Gray, until she got her apartment ready, and then naturally she wanted her piano up in her own apartment. But we've had very generous people. We have Mrs. Nita here who donated this piano. She's sitting back here someplace. We have Connie Chang who donated a piano that's on the second floor for those people up there. And then we have Arthur Hyde, our number one music lover, who has donated this beautiful digital piano. Oh, this is actually a loaner because they didn't have the kind of the color we wanted. We're going to get it more in natural wood rather than this black stain. It looks a little bit mortgage, you know. But would you just play a couple of tunes on there for us so they can hear what it sounds like? Back's going to be to you, but the piano company down the street, what's the name of it? Yeah, they sent a man up here to demonstrate this, but it was after he'd already started, so I sent him home. So you'll have to pardon his back. Like, what's that piano player from Denmark? Victor Morgan used to say, pardon my back and pardon my front, but that's the way I'm built.
This next selection is sort of a show-off kind of thing. And you may have heard me perform it the last time I was here. But this originated, I gave a concert with the Honolulu Symphony some years ago at the Blaisdell Auditorium. And they asked me if I would do something classical and that also had some Hawaiian in it as well, and it was popular. So I said, well, what did you have in mind? And he said, well, I thought the tiny bubbles would be very nice. Tiny bubbles. I said, well, so I dug up a lot of the classics that I used to play many years ago, you know, like Bach, Beethoven, Mozart, Chopin, Liszt, Rachmaninoff, and things like that. And I put this all together, and this is an arrangement that I came up with on Tiny Bubbles.
Thank you.
Can you play Happy Birthday? Happy Birthday?
Okay.
Listen, Happy Birthday to Arthur here, right?
All right.
That donated this lovely piano.
Yeah.
Happy Birthday to you. Happy Birthday to you. Happy Birthday, dear Arthur.
Of the day, who will be 88, what day? The 10th, on the 10th of April. So, happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Martin. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you very much, both of you.
Thank you. Thank you for having me play for you. I want to wish you all a very happy, a very happy Easter, and may the good bunnies take care of you. I hope you find a lot of Easter eggs. So until we meet again, we'd like to just wish you the very best, and yours truly, Martin Denny, wishing you a very fond, aloha. Thank you.